The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention relaxes its COVID-19 guidelines. The nation's top public health agency has dropped its recommendation for Americans to quarantine if they come into close contact with an infected person. People also no longer need to stay at least 6 feet away from each other. Officials say the changes are driven by a recognition that an estimated 95% of Americans aged 16 and older have acquired some level of immunity, either from being vaccinated or infected. Other changes recommended by the agency will be particularly important for schools, which resume classes this month in many parts of the country. These include an end to routine daily testing and the test-to-stay recommendation, which says students exposed to COVID could regularly test instead of quarantining at home.
U.S. Attorney General Merrick Garland confirms personally approving the search of Donald Trump's Florida home. Garland insists there was probable cause for the unprecedented action against the former president. He condemns what he calls unfounded attacks on the integrity of the Justice Department and the FBI that erupted after Monday's raid. Garland did not explain the reason for the search, but he says he has asked the court to make the case's documents public.
The department does not take such a decision lightly. Where possible, it is standard practice to seek less intrusive means as an alternative to a search and to narrowly scope any search that is undertaken. The department filed the motion to make public the warrant and receipt in light of the former president's public confirmation of the search, the surrounding circumstances, and the substantial public interest in this matter. Faithful adherence to the rule of law is the bedrock principle of the Justice Department and of our democracy. Upholding the rule of law means applying the law evenly, without fear or favor.
Trump has condemned the raid as politically motivated and a weaponization of the Justice Department. Leading Republicans have rallied around the former president, who was not present when the search took place. The total number of unemployed youths is seen falling to 73 million this year from 75 million. But the United Nations says that figure is still higher than pre-pandemic levels, with the recovery in youth unemployment lagging behind compared to other age groups. The UN's International Labor Organization adds the pandemic exacerbated the challenges young people are facing in the job market. Many dropped out of the labor force or failed to enter it altogether, due to the difficulty of finding a job during COVID lockdowns and a business's close. Globally, Arab states have the highest and fastest growing youth unemployment rate at nearly 25%.
And a look now at the financial markets. Wall Street's comeback rally took a breather Thursday as investors bet the Federal Reserve still needs to aggressively hike rates to fully tame consumer prices. The Dow nudged upward while the S&P 500 retreated. The tech-heavy Nasdaq fell 0.5%. Over in Europe, markets closed lower as investors assessed their monetary policy expectations after a cooler-than-expected U.S. inflation print and adjusted a raft of corporate earnings. And here in Asia, stocks rallied as investors in the region cheered a slowdown in U.S. inflation. Philippi shares outperformed, advancing 3.2% to 66.80.
Now, here are some economic data releases we're monitoring this Friday. Malaysia will post its second quarter growth print. Malaysia's economy expanded by 5% in the first 3 months of the year, beating market consensus supported by improving domestic demand amid easing COVID restrictions. The UK will also announce its second quarter GDP numbers. The British economy expanded 8.7% in the first 3 months of 2022, the highest in three quarters and in line with preliminary estimates. And India will come out with its July inflation report. Consumer prices in India dropped to 7% in June, below market expectations, but remained above the central bank's target range of 2 to 6% for the sixth straight month.
Russia and Ukraine accuse each other of new shelling. near the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant ahead of a UN Security Council meeting to address concerns over the facility's security. Both Moscow and Kyiv say there were five rocket strikes near a radioactive material storage area. The plant, Europe's biggest nuclear facility, has been a focus of renewed fighting in recent days. A pro-Russian official said Thursday that no contamination has been recorded and radiation levels remain normal. Still, the head of the UN's nuclear watchdog says the agency must be allowed to inspect the facility. Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky urging the international community to react immediately, warning Russia could cause an incident worse than Chernobyl. UN Chief Antonio Guterres also warning that continued hostilities around the facility could lead to disaster.